Good morning, children. Hope you all are safe at home. Welcome to the math class. Now, let us start with a new chapter, whole numbers. The very first one is predecessor. If you subtract 1 from a natural number, you will get its predecessor. Predecessor is nothing but the before number. To find the before number of a given number, we are going to subtract 1. Let us consider the example 199. To find the predecessor of this number, we are going to subtract 1. So when we subtract 1 from the given number, we will get 198. So 198 is the predecessor of 199. Let us consider one more example, 200. To find the predecessor of this number, we are going to subtract 1. So we will get 199. So 199 is the predecessor of 200. The next is successor. If you add 1 to a natural number, we get its successor. Successor is nothing but the next number. To find the successor of a given number, we are going to add 1. For example, let us consider the number 199. To find the successor of this, we'll add 1. When we add 1 to the 199, we will get 200. So 200 is the successor of 199. Let us consider one more example, 10,999. To find the successor of this number, we'll add 1. When we'll add 1, we'll get 11,000. So 11,000 is the successor of 10,999. Whole numbers. The natural numbers along with 0 form the collection of whole numbers. That means 0 along with the natural numbers are called as whole numbers. Now let us learn to plot the whole numbers on the number line. Observe the number line. You can make out that it has got the starting point, whereas you can also see an arrow here, right? This arrow indicates that the number will extend. The number will extend to the infinity. That means the whole numbers will have the starting number 0, where the numbers will keep on going. It has not got any ending at all. It extends to the infinity. Addition on the number line. Let us learn to add 2 numbers on the number line. Let us consider the 2 numbers 3 and 4 to be added. So see this number line. So the first number is 3. We'll start from the 3. The next number is 4. So from the 3, we'll move for 4 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4. Our answer is 7. That means the sum of 3 and 4 is 7. That is 3 plus 4 is 7. Let us consider one more example to add 2 and 3 on the number line. Consider the number line. The first number is 2. We'll start from the 2. The next number is 3. That means we'll move for 3 steps. 1, 2, 3. Yes, our answer is 5. That is 2 plus 3 is 5. Subtraction on number line. So let us learn to subtract 2 numbers on the number line. Subtract 5 from 7. So which is the greater number? 7. We'll start from the 7. We are going to start from 7 and we are going to move for 5 steps towards the left hand side because we are subtracting here. So from the 7, 5 steps towards the left hand side. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps. So our answer is 2. That is 7 minus 5 is 2. Consider one more example to subtract 5 from 10. Which is a greater number? Yes, it is 10. Let us go to the 10. So from the 10, I am going to move for 5 steps towards the left hand side because I am subtracting here. So from the 10 towards the left hand side, I have to go for 5 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my answer is 5. That is 10 minus 5 is 5. Multiplication on the number line. So let us learn to multiply 2 numbers on the number line. So to find the product of 4 and 3. Okay. Now, I just fix my step. I fix my legs for 3 steps. I fix my legs for 3 steps. And then I'm going to jump for 4 times. I fixed my legs for 3 steps and I'll jump for 4 times. You can observe here. 1 time, 2 time, 3 times and 4 times. And you can see have fixed my legs for 3 steps. So 4 into 3 is 12 and my answer is 12 here. Okay, and my answer is 12 here. Consider one more example to find the product of 2 and 5. Here what I do, I fix my legs for 5 steps. I fix my legs for 5 steps and I am going to jump for 2 times. I fixed my legs for 5 steps and I have jumped for 2 times. So my answer is 10. That is 2 5s are 10. Till now we have learned to add, subtract and multiply the whole numbers on the number line. Solve the questions from 1 to 6 from the exercise 2.1. In the next class, along with the key answers for the questions from 1 to 6 in the exercise 2.1, we'll continue with the properties of whole numbers. Thank you.